It's Lili Amanda for Portrait Creatives. In this video, we are going to talk about something really exciting, and I use it all the time for portrait retouching: frequency separation. First time when I heard about the name, I was like almost just freak out and froze, like, what is this in Photoshop? I couldn't understand what it is just from the name. I think the name is very technical, so don't worry about it. It just says it separates two things, which is texture and color and tone. You see a picture, there's texture, there are color and tone. With frequency separation, it can be separated and retouched and edited separately. And that was like, wow, godsend. When I first knew frequency separation, that was like some years ago, and I've watched so many tutorials for skin retouching, for portrait retouching, beauty retouching. They all mention about frequency separation. It is so important and it's so useful. Once you get to know it, you can do all sorts of things with it, and it's just so powerful and so easy to use. Don't be intimidated by the name. It's just basically about separating texture and color and tone. That's all. I'm going to share with you what is frequency separation and how you can use them, because these are just numbers to implement it. It's nothing you have to worry about, like the numbers and how to set up, because I recorded the action. You can just download it and then load it to your Photoshop, and with press a button play, it will load everything for you. But I'm gonna run through everything with you now. So if you want to create your own, you can as well. Let's go into Photoshop. We have this beautiful portrait of Christine. She's a professional dancer. It's someone who is so delightful to work with. With frequency separation, it's very simple. It's just two layers. Separate texture and then tone and color is another layer. So basically, we just have to duplicate two layers. I'm just gonna duplicate two background layers, and you can hold on to Command J twice to do it, or you can drag it to the plus sign and it will duplicate the layer. Okay, that's just like a couple of ways to do this. And then the bottom one, I'm going to name it color and tone. And the top layer, I'm going to name it texture. For you to easy to understand, texture is a higher frequency and color and tone is a lower frequency. But I like to think more practically, it's actually just texture and color and tone, okay? So I'm going to make the texture layer invisible right now, and we're going to work on color and tone layer. So with this layer, we are going to blur out the texture, okay? All the images are the same. It consists of texture and color and tone. Think about these are two separate layers. So first thing is, I want to create a layer without the texture. Eliminate all the texture. And then I use the background layer to subtract the color and tone, and then that will equals to texture. Okay, just simple math. So this one, I'm going to just erase all the texture. I'm going to blur it. There are also a way to blur the image, and I'm going to use filter, noise, dust and scratches. And I will just zoom in, just slowly to see like when the textures all disappear and only color and tone remain, okay? And every image is different, but you will be able to adjust it with the action as well, that it will pop up to a window to ask you what's the figure you want. Just about when the textures all disappear, you don't have to go overboard like this, right? So that's just like totally blur. When the image is so blur, there is no definition of tone and color. It's just like you're making a bread, like the dough, and mix everything all together. So there's nothing, there's no definition, okay? So we are going to blur the image when the texture just disappear, but the color and tone definition, like where is the highlight, where's the shadow, is still intact. That's very, very important. So it's about, I would say with this image, I would just go for 12 or 13. I'm going to go for 12. Okay, I'm click OK. So this image is blurred. You can see there's no texture. And that's exactly what we want. And with this layer, we are going to edit all the color and tone. So how we can bring the texture only to this layer? I'm going to make it visible right now. And then I'm going to image, apply image. And this is the time there are some numbers need to dial in, and I don't remember them. Exactly, I don't remember them because I use actions all the time. This is just my little notes. So this is frequency separation, and layer choose color and tone. Blending is subtract. Scale is 2, offset 128. Blending mode for the layer is linear light. Okay, so let's get back here. And choose image, apply image. Okay, so layer is color and tone, just like we just saw. Blending mode is subtract from here. And scale is 2, offset 128. And click OK. Okay, so this layer's texture is exactly from background, okay? And subtract from the color and tone, and we got a texture. These two combined together would be exactly the same as background, but we have to change the blending mode here. We're going to change to linear light. Okay, so let me just group these two together. You can hold on Command key and select two layers together and click on this folder and you will become a group, okay? This is frequency separation. You see, when I make it invisible, it's exactly the same, okay? Invisible is exactly the same image, okay? Nothing has changed. So that's the frequency separation. And how we can use it? So you can actually just download the action for these two layers. I don't really remember all these numbers and all this blending and scale are offset, but I have the figure over there if I need. And I record it as an action, so I can just go to my action and click on this frequency separation, Lili Amanda, and play. And then whole action will run through and I don't have to do it manually. If you want to have this action, you can find the link in the description to download the action. I'm going to show you how to utilize it, okay? So with color and tone, it's all about changing the color and tone. So you will go to this layer to do anything, to do something you want. For example, there's a little bit, tiny little bit shadow under her eyes. If I want to remove that, I have to tackle on color and tone. Okay, so I'm going to add a new layer here. Okay, so I'm not gonna touch this layer. I'm just gonna add here so I can add layer mask if I need to do any adjustment to it. So with this layer, I'm going to use clone stem tool. Okay, and then 20% and sample current and blur. So I'm gonna sample this area and just hold on Option key, smaller brush, and to sample this area. And then I'm just going to brush here because I only use 20% opacity. So I can go over a few times without going overboard. Okay, so I'm going to show you before and after. So the dark area under her eye is already disappeared. You can see that without touching the texture. You can see the texture is intact. Right? It's still everything there. And that's beauty about frequency separation. It is all about separating two things. So once I want to just bring up some brightness or I want to remove some patches of colors, this is the way to do it. And then, let me see, before and after. That's right. You see there are some hair over here, right? Strand of hair over here. I'm going to remove them with texture because hair has a lot of texture. Let's see how we can remove them with the texture layer. And I'm going to change to current layer because it has a blending mode. So we have to change current layer, okay? And opacity, I'm going to change it to 100% because I want to totally remove it. And then I'm selecting brush tool, 100% and current layer, okay? I'm gonna reduce my brush size just a little bit bigger than the hair, okay? I'm going to sample the area here, hold on Option key, sample, and just go over it. And that just disappear. So for texture layer, can remove hair very easily. So I can just go over here. I sample the area has no hair, but you can see there's still some color in it, right? Because that's the hair color still on it. But it does a very good job. So you get an idea about how you can utilize this tool. It's a very handy tool. You can see the texture still there. But the color, we will have to work on the color in a minute. Okay, I'm just gonna do here. So you can see there are some trace of patches, the hair patches over here. What we have to do is go back to the layer one here, to work on the color and tone area. So I'm going to do here, as well. So you can see the hair texture is all removed. Very easy, just like that. I'm on 100% opacity with the Micron stem tool. Okay. So it's all gone. And here, this is just one wrinkle she has. And you can see there's one hair across. You can see how easy it is for me just retouch it. Disappeared, right? And you can see that's me photographing her. And okay, so you can see there's some patches of different colors here, right? So I'm coming back here. I'm going to add another layer to adjust the color in tone. And I'm going to use the same clone stem tool, but I'm going to change the opacity to 20%. I use 20% because I want to gradually to build up the transition of the color instead of just copy and paste, okay? Because the clone stem tool, if you have it 100%, it's just copy and paste. So I'm gonna have my brush slightly larger and I'm gonna sample this area and just clone it here, okay? So the color will be blended much better together. Okay, so let me see. Oh, nothing has happened because we're on current layer. I'll change it to current and blur. Okay, so I'm gonna sample here and then just brush it. Okay. Like this. Okay. You can see I have gone a little bit overboard on the hair. But it's very easy. Like, let's see before and after. Okay, so it's much more smooth area without all the hair shadows. I'm going to add a layer mask. Okay, I'm changing to brush to black and change it to brush and then 100%. Okay. And then I'm just gonna paint this area because these are the hair. We don't want them to be affected, okay? So this is before and after, okay? Okay, these are the area we need to work on. Like, I'm just going back to my texture layer, opacity 100, sample current layer, okay? Let me just do a little bit more to clean up this area. Okay. Just like that. Okay. And then I'm just going to, I will add another layer. And then I'll use opacity 20% and current and blur. And then I will just gonna brush. I'm going to just clone this area. So it will look more natural blending in together. And of course, I will need a layer mask with black brush and then opacity 100. I'm going to just paint back this hair color like this. Okay, so it's not affected. So when you zoom out, see before and after. It's very clean, right? So I just retouch some of the area to demonstrate to you how you can utilize frequency separation for portrait retouching. It is so effective, right? And there are so many different ways you can use it and you can be creative with it. If you want to learn more about how to use frequency separation for portrait retouching, I have created a frequency separation course for portrait retouching, and you can find it on portraitcreatives.com. Once you join the membership, you can watch all the courses and tutorials. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. If you find value out of it, please give it a thumbs up. We will be uploading more helpful tutorials, so be sure you subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out any. And I'll see you in the next video.